This seat is mine. You can do nothing to displace me. better at 2, how could I have got the same A7?
Why are you asking me? Ask that secretary when he comes.
Oh, I will. Definitely.
One-act play or something?
You claim to be an avid patron of theatre arts for such a long time. Is this how you have been watching all the plays till date?
Well, what is a play for?
What is a play for?
Forgetting the little worries of home, the troubles of home, just for a few laughs.
Probably you have got a lot of troubles in your house, sir.
No. It's something which is common to every household. Some plays on that?
Has your wife come with you, sir?
If my wife comes over here, who will cook the food in the house? You!
Isn't that unfair to her? Doesn't she have to watch the play?
See, that woman doesn't understand one thing. She will come watch the play and laugh when the intensity of the play is at its peak.
So perhaps to her those parts evoke laughter. To each their own.
Anyway, Vishwa. Mr. Vishwa, please tell me today's play, what is it going to be about?
Before that, what kind of plays do you like to watch?
See, that is a tough one. The plays that I like and enjoy are long gone. I have grown up watching plays put up by legends. V.A. Chellappa. K.T. Sundarambal. Rajalakshmi. Why am I not surprised? Anyway, so as I was saying, I have grown up watching plays by put up such legends. When they begin to sing, the request for encores lasts well into the night. Voices rich in timbre. Oh, you must have definitely heard of Mr. Nawab Rajamanikam. How about the original voice company? Well, they used to rope in boys not more than the age of 10 years and put up quality acts in stage. Quality. See, I have also seen the Sampurna Ramayana come alive on stage where the character, Lord Hanuman, carries that Sanjeevani mountain on his bare hands and flies across the stage. Giants.
Okay, sir. Don't they still put up plays like this?
See? Not at all. Nowadays, all they do is wear some bulbs and burst some firecrackers on stage. No respect for the stage whatsoever. See, there are so many others. You know, artists from my time. Swami Shankardas, TKS Brothers, Avayar, stalwarts in the regard.
Hasn't those times long gone now?
Yes. You're right. That was the golden era of theatre. Those were the times.
And now?
Now. Just put some jokes together. Some politics. A typical Brahminical plot. There, you have a play on stage. See, back in the day, you did not require all this furniture on stage. All you had to do is close your eyes. Close your eyes. And follow the entire play. No offense to your friend over here. I was just speaking of theater in a very general sense.
I think you're being so judgmental right now without even having watched such good plays.
Well, are there any left? If there there are some good plays left, please tell me. Even I would like to have the pleasure of going and watching them. See, I will give credit where credit is due. See, back in the day, you know, the dancers on the stage used to dance with so much grace and poise. The singers used to sing so effortlessly. The actors back then did not require mics, and their voices boomed in the audience. Even a deaf and mute child sitting at the back of the audience could completely understand what's happening on stage. You know why, Mr. Vishwa? Because those plays had morals. They had principles. They were didactic in nature.
Are you saying all that is necessary for a play?
Yes, of course it is. Otherwise, what comprises of good theatre? Your joke festivals, your bulbs, probably.
Well, that is also a form of a theatre, sir. If actors start singing and dancing on stage, people will get up and leave. We are dealing with an impatient audience who don't have time to watch a protracted performance of singing and extended dance sequences.
All right. Okay. So, Mr. Vishwa, tell me, according to you, since you know so much about theatre, tell me what exactly makes good theatre. Educate me.
That you yourself is gonna see in some time.
No, go on, tell me.
I would love to, but before that I would like to resolve this issue of...
It's halfway done, I just think what are your... It's comfortable.
Yeah,
where are you? We've been waiting for you for so long. Yeah, come fast. It's a pink dress, right? Yeah, you look lovely in that. Yeah, come fast, we've been waiting for you. Okay. Yeah, I love you. Bye.
Girlfriend!
Excuse me?
I mean, see, this younger people, I'm telling you.
What's the problem?
Mr. Ravi, yeah, are you here? They are searching for you in the makeup room.
Raman, that's an issue over here.
Mr. Please, Raman!
Sir, come here, sir. Namaskaram, sir.
How are you?
Nalla irukken, sir. Sir. By the way, he is Mr.
Yes, I know who this personality is. Raman.
Sir.
Is it true that today's play has been written by him?
Yes, sir.
He is the author of today's play, sir.
Mr. Raman.
Sir.
Tell these two gentlemen over here, how long have I been a part of this theater?
Sir. From the very beginning, I think around 20 years. You know, we are planning to make a portrait of him next year.
Portrait of him?
Yes. Did you hear that? They are planning to make a portrait of me next year. Now tell them, Mr. Raman, how many years have I been sitting on this very same spot?
Yes, sir. Boy, what's the issue?
You have given them my seat, Raman.
Huh?
This reflects really bad on your organization skills.
Sir, I will check it. Sir, the ticket.
Well, how did this happen?
See, I told you.
Sir?
Yes. Now do the required.
Sir, I'm sorry. Can you just sit in a different row for today's play?
Why is it that this young man over here is entitled to a perk of not moving and you're asking me to shift?
branch.
I do not care who this man is, whether he is the actor, director, scriptwriter. See, Mr. Raman, what is a play without its audience? No, tell me, what is a play without its audience?
Correct.
And I suggest that you prioritize my interest over his in this matter.
But doesn't the playwright deserve some respect?
Of course the playwright deserves respect, so give him a different seat. Is my seat the only seat in the entire theater? There are so many free chairs.
Sir, all the seats are fully reserved. You see, you know, a police commissioner and a TV director are coming to watch today's play. Sir, we just sit in a different row for today's play.
Raman.
Honestly, no, sir. We didn't expect that you would show up for a play which deals with experimental theatre like this. Well, that is the reason for all this confusion. Sir, you come to the D row and watch the entire play so that you can enjoy it, sir.
Mudiyad, no, I will not move.
Sir, I'm sorry to say this. You are being too stubborn, sir.
I am being too stubborn? Huh? Am I being too stubborn?
Sir, would it hurt you if you just adjust for one day?
Why are you asking me to adjust? Ask him to adjust. He has the problem with this. Ask him to move.
Sir, I am telling you, he is the author, so he must only sit in the front row, sir. Sir, just four rows away, sir.
Mr. Raman.
Sir.
If you continue to pester me this way,
sir,
Mr. Raman, listen to what I'm talking.
Sir.
If you pester me to move out of this place, I will file a suit against
sir.
You for breach of conduct.
Sir.
Yes, I will drag you to the Supreme Court of India. I do not care if my entire wealth goes down the drain. I will see this to the very end.
Sorry, you just sit in the seat next to him. I think, it is Mr. Gopal, sir. He won't be too stubborn. Sir, you just sit in this seat for your entire life and watch the play. I will sort this issue out. So only I am working as a secretary, no? Mr. Ravi, I told you they are searching for you in the makeup room.
But Raman, I want Vishwa to sit here.
Okay.
Vishwa,
okay.
No.
It's okay.
Thank you.
Mr. Vishwa, you must understand something. See, don't you think life requires principles?
Of course.
Life requires principles. See, how is it my fault that the organization of this event is bad? Don't you understand my stance? See, you must understand. You must understand that there is no love lost between the both of us. The respect that I harbor for you hasn't been diminished by even one bit. But life requires principles. Don't you think?
Makes sense.
See, I do not blame you for this. This confusion. This fiasco of sorts. See, I have been like this my entire life. Fighting, arguing, trying to get what I want. What I think is rightfully mine, what I deserve. Once when I was of your age, I was working in Bangalore. As an accountant. You know what I did there? I took my employer to court.
Court?
Yes, Supreme Court of India. Now, ask me why.
Why?
Because he got me transferred? Yes. See, I told him, sir, this is not according to the book. This is against the principles of the company. I told him. But he didn't listen to me. Aha. He went ahead and stopped my promotion. Imagine. So I filed a suit against him. See, when a person completely devotes himself to a principle, he should not deviate from it. He should not compromise. That is how I have grown up, brought up, and that is what I have been following.
But now how does it work, sir? There's no progress without change.
Well, if you want change so badly, why don't you change? Why are you asking me to change?
It makes sense in a way.
Take this place. For an instance, see, the place that you like, I don't have to like, and the place that I like, I'm not forcing you to like them. See, the place that I like requires singing, dancing, and objects being thrown across the stage. Huh? You find all this ridiculous? Illa, I know you do. It's a joke, please. But am I enforcing all this on you? No. Doesn't a man have the right to be steadfast in his belief in the little time that he has in this world?
You are entitled to them as long as they don't affect or interfere with your immediate society.
How is me not letting go of this chair affecting anybody? Huh? Is there anybody here who's complaining except you?
What are you going to lose by letting it go?
What am I going to gain by letting it go?
It is just a fleeting instance. The values of you elders are hindering the progress of youth.
Hindering the progress of youth. See, are we elders, the older generation, expected to accept any kind of changes that you bring along? Is
Let me explain this to you.
Oh, please go ahead.
The days of singing and mountains being flown across the stage are well in the past. It doesn't appeal to the contemporary audience. They will not appreciate it. Take for instance, the authority and the responsibility in the government are being occupied by you people.
Okay.
Such a collective would be unable to accept the change that occurs as natural as evolution. Your values and your idiosyncrasies tend to silence any agents of change. I'm telling you, you end up enforcing your ideas on us.
Okay. Let's just say for argument's sake, I do agree to you know, what you're saying. Our ideas are being enforced on you, is that what you're saying? Fine. Okay. Tell me, Mr. Vishwa, so how will I know that the change that you bring along is good or bad?
First of all, it is pointless to label change as either good or bad. Without change, man will die out. Everything has to undergo change. Nothing is exempt. As we speak, the cells in our body changing, affecting critical metabolic reactions. You can do nothing to prevent it.
So I should not bother whether the change is good or bad? Yes?
Change doesn't care about being good or bad. Change is ruthless, unrelenting, and inevitable. One you will have to cope with. Today you're adamant. If your adamance is going to change a slightly greater section of a population, you'll be simply uprooted from your chair by a popular vote. That isn't just change. It becomes revolution.
I find it ridiculous. Ridiculous.
Oh, it will come, sir. Definitely it will.
Okay, let your change come. But please tell me, what time is your play going to start? You said 5 minutes to go, 5 minutes to go, and I keep asking you, what is your play about? Please explain to me what your play is about.
My play is about the very change we are talking about. According to you, a play is something which will have songs and lessons, morals, etc. But my humble opinion is, a good play is one that sheds light on a little pretenses, adamancies, and certain values. Just look at the number of things, the many facets of your personality. If I may, I have gained from the little conversation of us today. Firstly, the reason you told me for not bringing your wife. I don't think even that's a reason. Secondly, the change in your demeanor when you saw my friend. And finally, the change in your eyes. You moving to the Supreme Court of India. What's wrong with you? You moving to court for just not getting promotion? Probably you would have not deserved it. A better one would have gotten it. But no, it's your stubbornness. Don't you realize that it's people like you who decide the fate of this nation? The need to fight for something as paltry as an iron chair? When asked why, on principle. Well, sir, you kept asking me what my play is about, what my play is about. The answer is right here. This is what my play is about.
Who are the actors in your play? One is your friend, Mr. Ravi, that mannerless brute.
Excuse me. Yes, my friend Ravi, the secretary.
Mr. Raman?
Yes, Mr. Raman, myself, and finally it is you.
Thank you.
you. What do you mean by it's you?
The little exchange we have been having until now is the first part of the one act play, sir. Well, the rules of the game are now changing. Kiran, can you please switch the lights on? Well, this is what I've been trying to tell you all this while.
Smithy and Mahi for the lights, and Ruben for the sound system. I'd like to thank the Auroville Theatre group for giving us this opportunity for coming here and putting such a lovely play. I would like to introduce the cast and crew. On lights we had Kiran. On music we had Janice. On props we had Premchand. We had Ashun Vignesh as Mr. Vishwa. We had Rama as Mr. Raman. We had Ruben Jacob Nainan as Mr. Ravi.
We had Anurag Vikram Kate, who played the role of Sundaram and is the director of our play.